first public meeting is Godmen, Pseudosciences and Society. And from the Students' Federation of India, we would like to welcome Professor Narendra Nayak. I mean, this person who really needs one of the pioneering lies in the rationalist movement in this country. And there's this leaflet which has gone around, but a lot of things about this particular speaker who has come today. It has been his endeavor or his mission to try to discredit a lot of pseudoscience, a lot of junk science, and to take people towards a path of scientific temper and rationality. He has performed more than 2,000 demonstrations across the world, ranging from Australia, England, India, a lot of places, to debunk these myths. And he's written extensively on a range of topics, on the growing intolerance in our society, for example, or the entire issue of myth of, you know, this miracle men or God men. He's trying to debunk them. He's talked about the de-secularization of public spaces, and that is again a very key aspect of his work. In fact, as we believe that he's also pushing for this bill in the parliament which would seek to separate state and religion. From the Students' Federation of India, as a student body, we also think that it is necessary, not only on this campus but across our daily lives, to push forward this scientific temper and this understanding of a methodology of a scientific discourse which would allow us to understand or comprehend the world that we live in and to come to terms with it. Professor has promised that it's going to be an extremely interactive session where he is going to showcase some demonstrations to debunk these myths, and I would not waste any more time, and I would ask sir to take over.
I'm very glad that a big casual like that maybe 13 people into arranging this interaction, because it's my endeavor to get across as many people as possible in the few years that may be available to me where I can work actively. I'm one of the earliest members of SFI. I joined, I think, in 1972 or when it was formed. When I was studying my post-graduation in medical biochemistry at the Kasturba Medical College, Manipal, which was a capitation fee in university. That time it was just a college. Anyway, this has been a long journey since, and I'm very glad that so many of you have come, because I would like people to continue this work that I have been doing all my life. Past 3 decades, we have been working to promote rational thinking in this society. Secularism is a part of it. When you fight against the caste system, when you fight against the superstitions, when you fight against the exploitation, they are all a part of scientific temper. You cannot distinguish that just from sort of a miracle demonstration, which many people do as a sort of entertainment. And a class of people have done this to take people for a grand. For example, the double mister from Karnataka. I think it was in 2012 November that he went to IIT Kanpur and invited one of the boys from the audience. I think I'll also do that. One of you can do some of them. Yes. आजकल का जमाना है क्या ताकत, क्योंकि लोग मिलावट के खाना खाते हैं, प्रदूषण के हर पानी पीते हैं, प्रदूषण का हवा ये करते हैं, इसलिए not much strength, that's what he said. And then he said, हमने हिमालय में बने हुए जड़ी बूटियों से एक तेल बनाया है जिसको हम कहते हैं शक्ति ड्रॉप्स. ये तेल हमारे पास हिमालय से जड़ी बूटियों से बना हुआ. When I was in Uttarakhand for a tour and giving programs, there, everywhere the water will be coming from the inland. The driver would say, sir, पानी पीजिए. I said, क्यों? इसमें जड़ी बूटियों का सारा सत्तू मिला है, बहुत बढ़िया है पानी. तो So neither we got this study booty wale Shakti drops on the Himalayas. Iske haath ko lagaya. And this is a magical elixir which takes off all the effects of the pollution within 10 seconds. Now just watch. You know what happened there? This is a Jai Gurudev ki. Why did this happen at IIT Kanpur? And I went there in 2013 January. And when I was speaking to the student, they told me about this. And when I demonstrated this, they were flabbergasted because they had bought bottles and bottles of the Shakti drops, I think paying some 200 rupees for a small bottle, believing that this fellow has a concoction which removes all the effects of the pollution within 10 seconds. Imagine the most intelligent students of this country. I think it's IIT Kanpur is number one or two in the list of this IIT preferences. I think it's first or second.
First.
Yeah. And imagine these students falling for this bloody trick. And when I demonstrated there, they were shocked. They said, "Ye kya sir?" I said, "Yehi hai bhai." I was just too shocked. And they were also. Then they said, "We want to be trained in this." So we had a training program. What did I do? First time I bent his hand like this. Next time I caught it like this and bent it this way. You don't require a pylon like him to hold the hand. It could happen to anybody. So this is the sorry state of affairs today in this country, where a double mister takes people for a ride, saying that your lifetime is X number of breaths, and if you breathe Y times per minute, you will live for X Y divided by Y minutes. And if you breathe Y by two times, you will live for Y is the number of minutes. And if you breathe maybe 1 by 10th of the time, you will live for 10 times more. And as I said, extrapolating that, you take a deep breath and hold it, you will live forever. So the same thing should be extrapolated further. But in this country, we rarely ask questions. Any questions? Any questions?
Of course, start with it. From which to start? Any questions? No questions.
How many questions?
No.
Yeah? Shut up! How dare you ask me questions? What's your age? I'm 62, 63 years old and there ask me questions. This is the way questions are handled in our country. So a child is treated like this from a very, very young age, and hence the child will never appear. Or you can ask it later also. I won't do that again. But just to demonstrate to you how questions are handled in our society. Questioning is never, never encouraged. In fact, it is totally discouraged. That is why people fall for this so-called Godmen and Godwomen and maybe God children or maybe God people or whatever it is, without question. I have wonderful videos to show, but in the no arrangements I can show that, but you would have been shocked to hear some of the top people in this country praising a man who earned around 3 lakh crores through his cheap magic tricks, which any street magician would do better than him. He just used to wave his hand in the air like this, and then he would do it. And here it is.
Thank you.
will see his videos, you will see that he can give it only to 3 or 4 people. I can give it to 100 and keep on giving. So this is proof that I got supernatural powers by which I can make it. I know you, a lot of devotees of this guy, and some of them will say, he built hospitals, he built this, he did that, blah, 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 and what did you do? I said, at least I've exposed this. if you will smell this, you'll see that it's the same smell. Once I was going from Delhi to Gulbarga by train, and I met some people going to Gulbarga. And one of our common friends was there, he said, why don't you go and give them people? I went there and I said, Sai Ram. I said, Sai Ram. Then I waved my hands in the air and gave them vibhuti. I said, kya baat hai sir, wahi khushbu hai. Wahi swaad hai. I said, kyun nahi bhai, hum ek hi dukaan se. Same shop. It's called as Palani Vibhuti in this shop. And he buys tons of it, they are not good. I'm applying some petroleum jelly because my skin keeps on going off because of thousands and thousands of times I've given this university. Anyway, how did I do that? Very simple. Take here, vibhuti, mix it with congee water, maan they call it in Hindi, and then just make it into balls, dry them in the sun. And with this small ball, I can give vibhuti to 200 people. Because here it becomes as small. And when I powder it, it becomes small. And somebody said, he just doesn't give vibhuti, he also gives chain, watch, and whatnot. I said, how? They said, with empty hands. So both my hands are empty, nothing here. Just take it up, wave it in the air like this, and do like this. And we are these are bloody cheap tricks. But in order to get across to people, we have to utilize these bloody things. Because for the man on the street, the debate about the supernatural is not about the Big Bang theory or evolution or extrasensory perception or spoon bending or something, but it is about हमारे बगल वाली गली में एक बाबा है जो हवा में हाथ हिला के ये देता है या कोई जल उबलते हुए तेल में हाथ डाल रहा है या कोई अंगारों पे चल रहा है. So that is the sort of debate that the common man on the street brings to you. अगर आप कहते हैं कि किसी को ऐसी शक्ति नहीं है तो वो धकते हुए अंगारों पे वो कैसे चलता है, नहीं तो उबलते हुए तेल में हाथ डुबलता है, नहीं तो उबलते हुए तेल से पुड़िया निकाल के दे दिया मुझे, खुद अपने हाथों से निकाल के मेरे हाथ में दे दिया. और कभी कभी लोग कहते हैं मैंने अपने हाथों से दिया. ऐसे भाई मुझे तक आज तक कभी नहीं मिला जो दूसरों के आंख से देख लोग अपने आंख से ही. तो दिस इज द सॉर्ट ऑफ डिबेट अबाउट सुपरनैचुरल व्हेन यू गो टू द कॉमन मैन और द वुमन ऑन द स्ट्रीट. राइट नाउ इन द न्यूज इज वन बिग चमत्कारी अम्मा ऑफ केरल. Her actual name is Sudhamani. One of my earliest write-ups on the net was Miracles of Sudhamani, which is on a website called as Muktam. I think I wrote it around 10-15 years back. That was about her very famous miracles. You know, these people in the start with these cheap tricks. They gather people around them, then they start doing more expensive. And as they go on, they become more and more famous. Then they start new tricks like hugging people or blessing people or making claims or some business by people. Like that it goes on. On and on and on until they die. And even when the Puttaparthi guy died, he was kept alive for quite a long time. Yeah, he was kept on a ventilator. So that the oodles and oodles of cash that was lying around could be spirited away, and a lot of this one. And then near his, next to his bedroom, there was a big room with a biometric lock, which could be opened with fingerprints of only two people. One this guy And the other guy was from Bangalore. And they opened it, found Bhagavad Gita, thousands of copies of Bhagavad Gita, all puja things. Yes? Right? No. Not a single Bhagavad Gita, not a single puja thing, but golden chapels, golden thrones, crores of cash. That was what they found. So this is where the god business is all about. Earning money from gullible people. So how did I produce this? Very simple. This is called as skin color plastic. Yes. No. What's the most important part? Somebody said slate of hand. I said, no boss, sorry. The slate of the tongue. When you speak, people will be looking at your face and nobody will look at your hands. Bhaktagan, jab atma ka milan paramatma se ho jata hai. Tab mukti mil jayegi aapko. Ye laukik cheezon ko sab chhod do aur apni man lagao us paramatma par. जो हमें इस संसार सागर से मुक्ति दिलाएंगे। मैंने सही दिस वर्ड एवरीबॉडी उसे क्या बड़ी बात है बाबा जी ने ऐसे राज बताए सारे। And when you say आत्मा परमात्मा मैंने moment after this word everybody will be falling asleep.
Sir, एक चीज है हम लोग जैसे जितना भी मैटर हम देख रहे हैं वो 0.00001% है। हम उसकी स्टडी कर रहे हैं और वो भी हम जानते हैं कि कुछ भी नहीं आता हमें तो हम 0.00001% का हम नेग्लिजिबल हिस्सा जानते हैं तो ये कम बोल सकते हैं कि वो एग्जिस्ट ही नहीं करता कुछ
भाई अगर एग्जिस्टिंग होता है तो हमें सबूत चाहिए ना
हाँ
तो सबूत तो दिखाओ हम मान जाएंगे
तो वो बोलते हैं
अगर मैं कहूँ मुझे तो इस साइड में पाँच सर है उस साइड पे और पाँच है जो तुम छू नहीं सकते हो देख नहीं सकते हो
मैं ये नहीं बोल
रहा तो वही 0.001% के बाहर है ठीक है ना So when you make extraordinary claims, we need extraordinary evidence. And what can be asserted without evidence can be dismissed without evidence. Simple.
Sir, लोग जैसे बोलते हैं कि ओम चैंट करो। ओम चैंट एक ऐसा वाइब्रेशन है, ओम, आमीन, एमन। ये पूरी यूनिवर्स में जितने भी ऑब्जेक्ट्स रोटेट करते हैं, सबके एक्सिस से एक ये वाइब्रेशन का फ्रीक्वेंसी निकलता
है। कहाँ-कहाँ से आ गया रिसर्च? Fantastic है भैया। अगर ये रिसर्च सच हो गया मैं सोच रहा था कि पूरे दुनिया कोका कोला पे रोटेट हो रहा
है। I'm not saying कि ये
आवाज निकलती है। I'm not saying anything.
What I'm saying is कि इस फ्रीक्वेंसी की निकलती
है। क्यों क्यों किसने बताया?
आप करके देख लो, गूगल कर लीजिए आप।
So let us not try to simply गूगल का मानव नहीं करेंगे। You can get anything in Google if you want to type चप्पल्स और डॉग्स मैं डेट समथिंग में कमांड करूं तो आप तुम पे चप्पल पहने मुझे मालूम नहीं अच्छा क्या
हाँ अगर काटे वाली जगह पे लेके जा रहे तो बनाने तो पड़ेगी
हाँ बनाने तो पड़ेगा राइट अभी हम बात कर रहे हैं जो टैंजिबल एविडेंस का इन टैंजिबल एविडेंस से कुछ नहीं माने व्हेन इट इज इनटैंजिबल वी डू नॉट बॉदर अबाउट इट सो जब आत्मा और परमात्मा की बात हो रही है मैंने तो पूरे ह्यूमन बॉडी को डिसेक्ट किया है Gray's anatomy is the standard textbook of anatomy. In that, they have not written anywhere where this Atma is present. Then even in none of my textbooks of biochemistry say where this Atma is present. None of the textbooks of physiology have ever told me. I've studied anatomy and physiology for 1.5 years. And then I've studied biochemistry most of my life. And once one fellow told me, he told me a big shloka in Sanskrit. And he said, sir, why do you know Sukhino Bhavanti? He was on a TV panel discussion. I said, glucose to glucose, 6-phosphate, glucose, 6-phosphate to fructose. Fructose 1,6-diphosphate to glycerol, 3-phosphate to diphosphate. Sir, why do you know Sukhino Bhavanti? He was shocked. He said, ye kya mantra hai? I said, ye mantra hai, jisko hum glycolysis mantra kehte hai. Isko kisne dhoond nikala? I said, do rishi muni hai, jinka naam hai Emden and Meyerhoff. Jinhone mantra tamasha. और ये जिंदगी का मंत्र है सो इफ यू ट्राई टू टॉक थिंग्स लाइक दैट आई विल टॉक बैक इन माय ओन लैंग्वेज सिंपल सो लेट्स टॉक इन द लैंग्वेज व्हिच ऑल ऑफ अस कैन अंडरस्टैंड And this is the language of demonstration and discussion. If I had opportunity to show videos, I would have shown you the videos of the original man, of the 0.00001 person that you're talking about. How he was caught when he was trying to produce a necklace from thin air. How he has been caught when he tried to give this vibhuti. And he has got all the gyan of the world.
नहीं मैं ये नहीं बोल रहा कि वो पॉसिबल है मैं बोल रहा हूँ वो गलत है बट हम सब कुछ जानते नहीं जो उन और भी चीजों को गलत बोल सके
वो सारी चीज हम जानते नहीं है क्या कह रहे हैं do you know the structure of vitamin B12
no
still it acts as a maturation factor in your organism
yes.
I know the structure of that so what's the difference
right.
so if you want to take things at a tangent I also can take things at a tangent Let us try to confine ourselves to what is happening in the name of these so-called miracles, these so-called Godmen and so-called Godwomen. Now, this Godwoman from Kerala, her first miracle was lighting a lamp. This is from her authentic, authorized biography, Mata Amritananda Mai. She was Sudhamani in those days. Or when she was 12 years old, she did her first miracle. Of course, they said the first miracle was being born itself. Because she was born like this, with a female in Chin Mudra. And she started talking at the age of 6 months or something. And by the time of 4 years, I think she was in school. And by the time she was five, she was out of school also. And at the age of around 11 or 12, she started, I think you can read about her. There's this Treadwell, what's her name? Treadwell's biography of her is right now on the internet. I got a PDF document giving all the details of what she did later. But this was before she became Mata Amritananda. Right? At the age of 12, she was doing bhajans in a temple near her house. And she used to light a lamp because all our gods, you know, they can't see properly in the dark. So you have to light candles, light diyas, and things like that. So she used to put a lamp in front of them and do bhajans. And lamps do need oil. So she was taking the oil from home and putting it there. And her brother got angry. He said, "Ghar mein tadke ke liye bhi tel nahi hai, aur pura tel tum udhar barbaad kar rahi ho." So he took the lamp, threw it on the ground, got smashed into 1,000 pieces. Then when she went there, the lamp is smashed. So what to do? She went to the seashore. She collected seashells from there. She put a bati. No tail, what to do? So she put seawater, lit it with the lamp. And what happened? It burned. So that was her first, second miracle. First one was being born. The second one was lighting her lamp. Now I think she's going to do it. Why not? Come here. Now, here I told Akhu to bring seashells. What is seashell? I took a lamp now. Here I'm putting a bati. And then I think we take this water. Open it. Just check whether it's water. You check. Drink it. Yeah. Because you have to prove that it's water and not something else. What's it? Pour it into this. Now you take the matchbox and light a tank. अगर ये दिया जलेगा तो हम आपको चमत्कारी अम्मा मानेंगे. If not, थप्पड़ देंगे. मंजूर है? मंजूर है. ठीक है. So here it is. So yes. Is this the way to treat a chamatkari amma? Somebody whistle. So, Jai Ho Mata. So here we have a chamatkari amma who can light a diya with the water. So we have to naturally agree that she is a chamatkari amma. And I think there are some vacant spaces which are noted here. And by tomorrow afternoon we are going to open our ashram there. And she will do chamatkars there, and we'll have a long line of people coming, including the President of India and the Prime Minister. The present Prime Minister and maybe the next one also will come. So this is the sort of thing that happened in our country. That was the second miracle. You know what was the third miracle? Are you going to do the third miracle? Right. The third miracle on Osteopathy. When you hear of the third miracle, you want to do it. A third miracle was, there was a guy called Dattan who wanted to come to her satsangs. This is a dutsang. That's a satsang. Because it's a gathering of all bad people. And her gatherings are satsangs, gatherings of good people. And there somebody wanted to join in her bhajans. And nobody was allowing him to come near her because he was a leper, suffering from Hansen's disease, and pus all over, oozing and smelling, and so nobody was allowing him to come. She called him near, licked his wounds, applied vibhuti, and he got cured. So that was the third miracle. So like that, there's a long list of miracles of this. And finally she started hugging people, and then she became famous as the hugging Amma. And then, of course, followed by millions and millions of foreign aid and whatnot. So this is how these godmen and godwomen take people for a ride. Start with some chiller miracles, then get publicity. And then there are enough number of people in this world who are on the lookout for these so-called miracles. So they'll come. Rumors will fly around, people will start believing it, politicians will flock there, and they will be endorsing the miracles, and so the whole shop opens. This is what we have seen in the case of so many of these so-called miracle men and women. You have guys like Asam Al Harpalani, who's also called as, what is his name?
Asaram
Bapu, who made thousands of crores. And he had an affinity for young girls also, which landed him in trouble, you know that. Of course, the man who died had an affinity for young boys. It was more like Catholic priests in that. But there are so many allegations, and there were 6 bodies in his bedroom. That was in 1992. Nothing happened. Because the Home Minister of India was a chela of this man. The then Prime Minister of India, P.V. Narasimha Rao, was a chela of this man. Why? Do you know the reason why these politicians go after this government? Do you think they have vote banks? No. They have Swiss banks. Don't need to go to Switzerland to bring the black money. There's enough black money lying around these ashrams of Godmen, which belongs to all these religions. If you had seen the videos of the deathbed, I mean the body of this Puttaparthi man lying, you would have seen the national hero Sachin Tendulkar, Bharat Ratna, sitting and weeping there. Know why? Somebody said he had got 60 crores of this man's money. So they are the major conduit for black money and a lot of other things that happen. Now, any more questions? Now let's go back to questions. Yeah.
Sir, can I say that today जितने भी हॉस्टल के रूम हैं सभी में हनुमान जी या मंगलवार का व्रत हमें से सभी करते हैं तो हम आज भी मस्जिद में जीते हैं जहाँ पैसा पूरा मंदिर या मस्जिद में जा रहा है
या चर्च में जाएगा
या चर्च
में जाएगा
जो कि वेस्टर्न में कॉल्स हुआ था अब हम उसी में जी रहे हैं यहाँ तो अभी भी निशान
यस निशान नहीं आया क्योंकि हम क्वेश्चनिंग ही नहीं कर रहे छोटे उम्र से ही हमें बताया जाता है दिस इज अ पार्ट ऑफ अवर फ्यूडल पास्ट पहले ऐसे था कि राजा महाराजा हमें रूल करते थे बाद में अंग्रेज आ गए बाद में आ गए हमारे राजनीति वाले द कांग्रेस में पीपल तो ऑफ कोर्स सॉरी ड्यू अपोलॉजीज टू द कांग्रेस पार्टी मेंबर किया, बाद में कांग्रेस वाले, बाद में आए दूसरे सब, एंड क्वेश्चनिंग समबडी इन पावर वुड कॉज वुड फिनिश यू ऑफ. इसलिए एवरी माँ टेल्स हर बच्चा कुछ पूछना चुप है. That's why we never ask questions. Nothing never came because of that. And the other danger in this country is we have got a 16th century mindset. हमारे मानसिकता तो बिल्कुल 16th century में है, लेकिन technology तो 21st century का है. That's a very potent, dangerous combination. 16th century का mindset और 16th century की technology लो तो ज़्यादा नहीं होगा. वो 16th सेंचुरी वाले के हाथ में एक तलवार था, नहीं तो वो तीर लेके जाता था. लेकिन आज क्या हुआ, इसके हाथ में AK-47 मिलेगा, एटम बम मिलेगा. मेंटालिटी वही होती है, एंड विद दैट ही कैन फिनिश मिलियंस ऑफ पीपल. एंड उस जमाने में अगर कुछ ऐसा चमत्कार होता था तो वो न्यूज़ कश्मीर से कन्याकुमारी तक पहुँचने को 10 साल लगते थे अगर गया तो. अब तो 10 मिनट में होता है. दिस इज द वेरी dangerous state of affairs where our educational system is training you right from KG. Never, never question. Just accepting. Choti mu badi baat chup hai. Kya samajh rakha hai apne ko? That is the way they will train the child right from a very young age. And as the child grows up, it will learn more and more hypocrisy because he's sees the things happening. If for a child, hey, bhai, ye karo, tum ek chocolate de dunga. You are teaching the child corruption at a very young, young age. And the child sees the father taking bribes. So what will the child do when it grows up? For that child, corruption becomes a way of life. The same way they will be doing puja, art, everything. So because of that you think that everything over I because of this puja part. And again we have got people like Manu who told us 1500 years back that barish sahi waqt pe ho raha hai, suraj ho raha hai, isliye ki brahmano ki puja part se. So sare logon ka kaam ye hai ki brahman ko happy rakhe, ki wo puja part karte rahe aur ye sab cheeze waqt pe sahi waqt pe ho jaye. So with this mentality we become more and more going into this. And we, if we can't do pujas, go into the mandir, go to the net and do one puja. If the Purohit can't read the mantras, he will bring a CD player and put the mantra there and play it. So we are technologically very friendly. But mentality, why is we are still in the old days? That is one thing, peculiarity of this country. Of course, like that in United States also there is the Bible Belt where the southern parts where they take everything literally. So just the advancement of technology doesn't mean the advancement of thinking. Any other question? How did this chamatkari humma like this na?
Sawal ye hai, Nayak ji. Aksar चमत्कार ये लोग करते हैं जो फर्जी बाबा लोग हैं, सो कॉल्ड पाखंडी हैं, ढोंगी हैं, तथा कथित रूप से महान भ्रष्ट हैं, और मार्केट में तथा कथित झोला छाप डॉक्टर की तरह झोला छाप ज्योतिषी भी बैठे हैं, चैनलों में प्रवचन कर रहे हैं, ज्योतिष का प्रचार कर रहे हैं, तरह तरह की चीज़ें. सवाल ये है कि तकनीकी विकास और वैज्ञानिक विकास के बावजूद आप जैसे लोग बहुत कम हैं जो मीडिया में आते हैं या इनके तरह तरह के संजाल को, जाल को तोड़ने के लिए खड़े होते हैं. बहुत कम लोग होते हैं कि तोड़ने के लिए खड़े होते हैं. सवाल अब सुनिए, ये जो आपने चमत्कार साइंस के थ्रू तमाम कुछ प्रयोगों, कुछ तत्व हैं, केमिकल हैं, उनके जरिए आग जलाना, जैसे सोडियम वगैरह के जरिए तरह तरह की चीज़ें हैं, हर केमिस्ट्री पढ़ने वाला जानता है. एक स्टेटमेंट भी है और क्वेश्चन भी है, ध्यान दीजिए. साइंस के थ्रू मैजिशियन भी चमत्कार दिखाता है, लेकिन मैजिशियन का दावा करता है कि मैं भी तथा कथित रूप से ये बाबा हूँ. कोई भी जादूगर दुनिया का आज तक ये दावा करता है कि मेरा भी प्रवचन सुनने आइए, गॉडमैन में हूँ. कोई भी मैजिशियन क्या आज तक दावा कर पाया या करता है कि कि मैं भी सो कॉल्ड गार्ड मैन हूँ, वो क्यों नहीं करता?
आपका सवाल क्या है?
मेरा सवाल यह है कि एक मैजिशियन भी साइंस की डिवाइसेस के थ्रू ही चमत्कार करता है, लेकिन वह गार्डमैन होने का दावा क्यों नहीं करता?
अच्छा, वो वेरी गुड क्वेश्चन। मैं और इंडिया के सबसे बड़े मैजिशियन पीसी सरकार दोनों एक टॉक शो में थे, NDTV का मैजिक मिरेकल। सॉरी, ही सेड माय गॉड विद द बॉक्स ऑफिस More people come to see my program, happier I am. दूसरा एक फुटेज है इनका जो कहते हैं कि we can also do the same things, but we will not do it because those who are doing it are taking the country back. We want to take the country forward. So that is why a magician कभी ये दावा नहीं करता कि उसको एक बार जो हुआ था, there is a movie called as Live India or something, headquarters is in Delhi. वहाँ मुझे बुलाया गया था, एक लड़की, इसका नाम था रंजना अग्रवाल, बोले थे कि वो आँख में पट्टी बांध के वो पढ़ सकती है, आँख में पट्टी बांधती है, यहाँ कुछ रखती है और पढ़ती है। मैंने बोला इसके आँखों के सामने पकड़ो, so वो पढ़ नहीं सकी, because this is a magic trick, this would be supernatural. और वो रोने लगी बाद में, वो छोटी लड़की है क्या करें, एंड एवरीबडी विल बी अगेंस्ट मी बिकॉज़ छोटी लड़की को बुला गया। सो हमको मैजिक और मिरेकल के बीच में ये फर्क देखना चाहिए। माने मैजिशियन इज एन एंटरटेनर, वो एंटरटेनमेंट के लिए करता है, वही ट्रिक्स जो गॉडमैन करता है वो कहता है कि हम चमत्कारी शक्ति से करते हैं। तो हमारा मकसद मैजिक को एक्सपोज करना नहीं।
नहीं तो क्यों फंसते हैं, हम ही आप फंसते हैं ना, हम क्यों जाते हैं उनके पास, हमारी क्या जरूरतें हैं? मैं कहता हूँ हमने उनको महत्वपूर्ण बनाया है, वो नहीं है, वो धूर्त है, वो चालबाज है, तो हम उनको महत्व देते हैं ना, हम अपना पैसा टाइम एनर्जी बर्बाद करते हैं, उनके पाखंड को हम बढ़ाते हैं,
पाखंड को
धोखा तो हम स्वयं को देते हैं।
मैंने तो जवाब पहले ही दिया था इसको,
बिल्कुल,
क्योंकि हम छोटी उम्र से ही हमको क्वेश्चनिंग डिस्करेज करते हैं। इस कारण अगर आप प्रश्न पूछ सकते थे तो आप पूछते थे कि ये कैसे आ रहा है, वो क्यों एक ऐसी छोटी मोटी चीज़ दे रहा है, क्यों ना वो कद्दू निकाल के दे या कोई बड़ी चीज़ दे। एंड कभी कभी हमारा फॉल्टी लॉजिकल थिंकिंग भी होता है, देखिए अगर मैं आपको खुश करने के लिए आपको खुश में दे दूँ, ऐसे में हवा में ऐसे हाथ हिलाता हूँ, और आपको चुप करने के लिए मैं आपको खुश करता हूँ, ये लीजिए आप खुश हो जाइए, आपको काम करने की जरूरत है।
लेकिन मैं नहीं खुश होऊंगा ना, मेरे सवालों के जवाब नहीं मिले, सवाल ही नहीं आएगी।
देखिए मैं जवाब इसी में है, देखिए लॉजिकल थिंकिंग, ए लिमिटेड लॉजिकल थिंकिंग हमें कभी कभी भटकाता है,
बिल्कुल
लिमिटेड लॉजिकल थिंकिंग माइंड, बिकॉज यू थिंक दैट दिस नॉट केम फ्रॉम थिंग, फॉर द सिंपल रीजन दैट आप सोचते हैं कि यह नोट इतना बड़ा होता है, कैसे उंगलियों में छिपा सकते हैं, हाथ में पकड़ा था देख सकते थे, दिस इज लिमिटेड लॉजिक। इफ यू थिंक फर्दर यू विल नो दैट दिस नोट कैन बी फोल्डेड लाइक दिस एंड इट कैन बी मेड स्मॉल एंड इट कैन बी केप्ट लाइक दिस इन बिटवीन योर फिंगर्स, और बोलते बोलते इसको हवा में हाथ हिला के इसको हम प्रत्यक्ष कर सकते हैं। And you will think that if you had hidden this note somewhere and if you had removed the fold, you would have seen it. आप देख नहीं सके थे क्योंकि मेरे हाथ हिलते थे। So that is why I am saying, आपके logical thinking आगे बढ़ाइए। हमारे लोग यहाँ क्यों जाते हैं? इसलिए इनके mind में gap होता है। उस gap से अंदर घुसते हैं ये लोग। क्योंकि हमने सुना है, हमने देखा है बड़े-बड़े लोगों को कहते हुए। For example, T.N. Sheshan was a middle class hero. Big election commissioner, chairman of the election commission, chief election commissioner, वो बोल रहे थे कि I am wearing this ring which came from Thine, Sai Baba gave it to me, I got a master's degree in physics, I got a master's degree in business administration from Harvard, I see nothing wrong between the physics and that this came out of Thine. जब कोई ऊपर बैठा हुआ आदमी ये कहता है तो हम इसको सच मानते हैं क्योंकि हम बोलते हैं कि ही इज नॉट ए फूल. Somebody said, can Station a fool? I said, yes. Why not? If he says that Hawa sent gold aa sakta hai, toh he's a fool. I will say that. I won't hesitate to say that. So, हमारे mind में जो gap रहता है, इससे अंदर घुसते हैं लोग और अंदर पूरा फैल जाता है. Because right from a young age, you are taught that there are certain people जिनको ऐसी शक्ति होती है जो मामूली इंसानों में नहीं होता. If you have been taught right from a young age कि सारे के सारे लोग समान होते हैं, कोई ऊंच नहीं, कोई नीच नहीं है, तब हमारे बच्चे पूछते हैं वो कैसे करता है, वो कैसे कर सकता है. हमारा conditioning ऐसा होता है, so we have to overcome that conditioning. That is what is very important for us. If not now, maybe as you keep on thinking. वो थिंकिंग प्रोसेस तो जागरूक करना है लोगों में, इसलिए हम ये काम कर रहे हैं. जागरूक कैसे करें? अगर आप एम्प्टी थियरी बोलते जाए तो कहते हैं साला इस कान से जाएगा दूसरे कान से बाहर निकलेगा. लेकिन ऐसे चीज़ों के साथ जब करें तो लोग सुनने बैठेंगे, they'll get interested. तो इसलिए हमने ये चीज़ों को एक विजिटिंग कार्ड के रूप में इस्तेमाल करते हैं. दिस इज नॉट ऑल आवर मूवमेंट इज अबाउट. This is the visiting card of our movement. That vaigyanik soch karo, cause and effect relationship ke baare mein socho. How do you define a miracle? Kaise define karte hai chamatkar? How do you define a miracle? Wahi jo magician karta hai, isko jab ye log karte hai, isko miracle kehte hai. Kyunki magician to entertainer hota hai, wo koi trick karta hai. Lekin hamare jo baba mein aisi shakti hai ki wo apni shakti se ye karta hai.
ये सवाल ये है, मैं कह रहा हूँ, आपने कहा हमारे यहाँ वैज्ञानिक सोच का नितांत अभाव है, बहुत कमी है इस चीज़ की. लेकिन हम चाहते क्या हैं? हमारे ऊपर जो हमारी पीढ़ी है आज की, उसके पास पेशेंस और सहनशीलता की कमी है. हर थोड़ी सी परेशानी का वह इंस्टेंट कॉफ़ी की तरह सॉल्यूशन चाहता है. हर सॉल्यूशन वो इंस्टेंट कॉफ़ी की तरह चाहता है, बटन दबाया और मिल गई. तो जाता है गॉडमैन के पास और गॉडमैन आप बना देते हैं उसे. वो तो बनने के लिए तैयार ही है, वो धूर्त तो है ही है. आप थोड़ा भी कष्ट नहीं झेल पाते हैं और चूरन पहुंच गए इंस्टेंट कॉफी के लिए.
देखिए
तो ये पेशेंस भी तो होना चाहिए.
जब आप इंस्टेंट कॉफी के लिए जाए और इसमें सिर्फ पानी निकला है, तब इनको पीने के बाद पता लगता है कि इसमें पानी
आ रहा है. तो चले जाने के बाद पता चलता ही है, तभी तो जहां से आराम खुल के आ जाते हैं ना, वो बाद में खुलता है.
इनको इनके पास जाने से हम कैसे रोके लोगों को? क्योंकि इनको छोटी उम्र से ही वैज्ञानिक सोच सिखाना चाहिए. ये एक तरीका है वैज्ञानिक सोच सिखाना, खुद करके देखो.
Sir,
some time ago,
a lot of people would know Dr. Dhabulkar, another
fellow
nationalist, was brutally murdered.
Yes.
So I just
want
to ask you, have you, you know, faced
threats? He was my vice president for 3 years. I know him very well. I gave him a because he's no more. He is a very good friend of mine.
No, I just
want to
ask you, have you faced threats of that kind? If you could tell us, yeah. Share some of those experiences.
Why should I bother about it? Anyway, those days are over. Now I think there will not be any more threats. It will just be carried out. That's it. But I'm not bothered about it. That one has to die someday or the other. I know that. Two times I used to go by two-wheeler in those good old days. The rear brake cable of my scooter was cut and left on a few slacks. If it is totally cut, you know very well that when you are starting, then it breaks. They were left with a few strands intact. So that when I give the brakes the most, when I apply the maximum power to stop, the cable will get cut and I'll die. 2 times it was done, and each time when I took to the garage, they said, "Humne kabhi ye cable cut hote hue nahi dekha." This thick cable. That was a Vijay Super scooter which I had. 2 times it was done, and it was very clear that it was cut, because I showed to a metallurgist, he said it's cut with hacksaw blade. Once, when I was demonstrating that Ganesh idols don't drink milk, a mob came and threw stones at me, had a skull injury. Then, threats keep on coming, and now they have stopped. After caller line identity, this came, the threats have stopped. Previously, I used to get letters, nowadays nobody writes letters. They have stopped. was, they tried to kick me out of the job. I was working for Manipal University, and naturally you know that no private management will tolerate a person like this attacking Godmen left and right. So they tried to throw me out. From my designation was changed from, they couldn't throw me out, obviously, because I was a good teacher. So they changed my designation from assistant professor to biochemist. A new designation suddenly invented. Because they wanted me out of the academic council of Mangalore University, where I was elected by the teachers. And when they changed my designation, I went to the court. And you know how our courts are. It took 5.5 years for the courts to say that this order is illegal and it is set aside. So for 5.5 years, I was drawing full salary. I was getting increments on time, but I was prevented from teaching. So what other work can a teacher do if you prevent a teacher from teaching? So I was just sitting and going around the country writing books. And after I won my case, they couldn't do anything to me. So in 2006, I decided to quit, to devote all my time for the movement. And they said, you are a fool, UGC scales are coming. I was not bothered. Let any scales come, I'm quitting. So I quit because there was an incident which really shook me. An 8-year-old girl was kidnapped in a village in a district called as Gulbarga in Karnataka. She was kidnapped to be sacrificed. Villagers knew that, but nobody dared interfere in that because they were all scared of the people who had kidnapped her. And after 3 days probably of starvation or something, she was flayed. And that mantrik was sitting on the skin, it's him and trying to visualize it in treasure. And the whole lump of meat was thrown roadside. When I heard of that, I thought that when things like this are happening in our country, what's my point in sitting in my room and taking my classes and doing a bit of research and guiding a few PG students? I thought I'll quit and devote all my time for the movement. And there we had a big campaign against this so-called black magic called as Bhanamati in those areas. In border areas of Hyderabad, Karnataka, this so-called black magic called as Bhanamati. So then, after campaign in that area, lots of changes are coming over there. But still, there are some people who are still after all these things. There is something called as Dying Prasa. Particularly in the tribal areas, Odisha, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh, and even parts of Bihar. We have taken a lot of training programs there to train people to demonstrate that nobody has supernatural powers. यहाँ इन लोगों का मकसद है कि हम ये दिखाना है कि हम आपसे अलग हैं. I am different from you, I am superior to you. Since I can produce vibhuti from thin air, that vibhuti can cure all your diseases. Since ye anguthi hawa se nikali hui hai, iske pehle to sare aapke problem dur ho jaye. Once I was having a training program in Tatanagar, and one man shows me a tabiz. He said, kitne mein aayega? I said, iska 5 rupaye 10 rupaye hoga. He said, maine isko 400 rupaye diye. I said, kyun? Baba ne mujhe hawa se nikal ke de diya. So 5 rupaye ka tabiz 400 wala ho gaya. Because isko bandhne se, and some people get cured. Again, why? That's a very, very important question. Why quackery survives? Many of my friends who are general practitioners, family doctors, not specialists, say that 80% of our patients ko koi treatment ki zarurat nahi hai. Self-limiting disorders. Some viral infection, some diarrhea, some bacterial infection which will heal itself, they will give you only something to relieve the symptoms. So whether you tie a tabiz, whether you take Baba's ashirwad, or whether you take his vibhuti, 80% of the people will become all right by themselves. So that is why they thrive. Homeopathy ka good dawa khao, theek ho gaya. Kyun? Placebo effect hai bhaiya. Homeopathy is called as very harmless. I was in Punjab. There one woman told me, sir, मैंने एक महीने की दवाइयाँ लाकर रखी थी टेबल पे और मैं नहाने गई, मेरे बच्चे ने सारी गोलियाँ खा ली. सो शी गॉट स्केयर्ड, बच्चे को पकड़ के उसके होम्योपैथिक डॉक्टर के पास भागते भागते गए, डॉक्टर साहब मेरे बच्चे ने एक महीने की दवाइयाँ सारी खा ली, अब क्या होगा? जी सर कुछ नहीं होगा। जी सर क्यों? जी सर हमारे दवा का कोई साइड इफेक्ट है ही नहीं, जब मेन इफेक्ट नहीं है तो साइड इफेक्ट है। यहाँ तो यू हैव गॉट थ्री, इमेजिन इन अ कंट्री लाइक दिस यू हैव गॉट थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ सिस्टम्स ऑफ मेडिसिन। वन इज व्हाट यू कॉल एज एलोपैथी, विच इज अ रॉन्ग, इट्स नॉट एलोपैथी, इट इज एविडेंस बेस्ड मेडिसिन, साइंटिफिक मॉडर्न मेडिसिन। सेकेंड इज दैट इज एविडेंस बेस्ड एंड इट इज ऑल्सो रिकग्नाइज। द सेकेंड टाइप इज रिकग्नाइज बट नॉट एविडेंस बेस्ड। ये तो आप लोगों का आयुष पूरा उसमें आता है, आयुर्वेदा, योगा, यूनानी, सिद्धा, होम्योपैथी, इसका कोई सबूत नहीं है। एंड द थर्ड टाइप इज नाइदर रिकग्नाइज नॉर एविडेंस बेस्ड, इन दैट म्यूजिक थेरेपी, अरोमा थेरेपी, इलेक्ट्रो होम्योपैथी, रेकी, प्राणिक हीलिंग, एक्यूप्रेशर, एक्यूपंक्चर, व्हाट इज दैट, हिप्नोथेरेपी, ऑल दैट बिग लिस्ट ऑफ पैकेजेस इज देयर। एंड आई एम टेलिंग यू दिस वेरी वेरी कॉन्फिडेंटली, व्हाई? It's not I who says it. Supreme Court of India has said that. Why Ayush is still there is for the simple reason that they have got a large body of literature, large number of people still follow it. That is why the Supreme Court has said, yes, let them be there. But the third type, they have said, no government shall sponsor them, no government shall recognize them, no government will give any grants for any of these, music therapy, aromatherapy. What nonsense you are talking. But still, they are still thriving in our country. You have got an institute of nutritional therapy on your campus, many institutes of nutritional therapy. What is that? Canteen. If you don't eat, you will die, na? So eating is nutritional therapy. So you could call things like that. This is a major part of our irrational things that are there in our society, just like astrology, palmistry, all these miracles, all the healings by prayer. You have got things like this. You have even got psychic surgeons. Those operate with bare hands. Kali haath se operate karte hain, phir operate karne ke baad andar jo hai buri cheeze, cancer jaisi cheezon ko nikalte hain. Phir kya karte hain malum hai? Jahan jo incision kiya वहाँ तो ठीक होना चाहिए ना, वहाँ स्टिचेस नहीं डालते, अपना एक चमत्कारी मलहम लगाते हैं जिससे वो बिना किसी दाग से ठीक हो जाते हैं। वो ऑपरेशन किसी पर डेमोन्स्ट्रेट करो, ये Why do you want to volunteer him? You come. How are you? Your name? क्या नाम? तो तुम्हें मालूम होगा कि एक चमत्कारी बाबा है जिसको कहते थे असलम बाबा, कर्नाटक वाला। वो ऐसे करते थे कि चाकू चूरी से ऑपरेशन करते थे। और मैं इसको रस्सी से क्यों बांध रहा हूँ मालूम है? कभी कभी ऑपरेशन करने के समय आंते निकल जाते हैं। एक बार मैं झुमरी तलैया में एक पेशेंट पे ऑपरेट कर रहा था, इसके पूरे आंते निकले थे और वो भाग गया, न जाने बेचारे का क्या। तो इसलिए आजकल मैं पेशेंट को बांध के रखता हूँ, क्योंकि जब इसका अंदर का कैंसर निकाले तो बाद में वहाँ बूंद लगानी है ना और मरना। सो एक जमाने में मैं अपने खाली हाथ से ऑपरेशन
मेरे स्किन की कैंसर है
यार। अच्छा दोबारा तो हम बड़ा ऑपरेशन चाकू देख के ही डरते, तो हम इसको ऐसे करते हैं, कैंसर के लिए ऑपरेशन करना पड़ेगा, ऑपरेशन करने से पहले हम अपना गोंद का डेमोन्स्ट्रेशन देते, क्योंकि आपको हम पर भरोसा नहीं है
ना,
एनेस्थेसिया की जरूरत है, तो इसको हम काट के फिर से जोड़ देंगे। तो मनुष्य पर ऑपरेशन करने से पहले प्राणी पर एक्सपेरिमेंट किया जाता है, एनिमल एक्सपेरिमेंट। आई आस्क्ड टू ब्रिंग अ डॉग,
नहीं मिला,
ही इज नॉट एग्रीइंग, सर फ्रोज एंड कुत्ता इज नहीं मिला। ऐसा करते है कि माउस पर एक्सपेरिमेंट करने से पहले इनएनिमेट ऑब्जेक्ट पर करेंगे। तो ये खींची लेना और इसके दो टुकड़े कर दो, ओके? आप बेंड नहीं कर सकते ना, तो काट कर दिया, दो टुकड़े कर दिए, एक तो इधर है, इधर है। देखिए, एवरी ऑब्जेक्ट हैज गॉट व्हाट इज कॉल्ड एज अ प्राणिक ऑरा अराउंड इट, एंड अगर ऑरा टूट जाए तो कोई कुछ नहीं कर सकता। सो वो प्राणिक ऑरा टूटने से पहले मैंने ये दो लेकर यहाँ ज्वाइन कर दिया। अच्छा, आप एक देखिए खींची नीचे, ही इज डाउटिंग, आप एक गठन लगाए इसमें, गठ लगाना इसमें, अच्छा, क्योंकि ही इज नॉट बिलीविंग इन मी, आप मुझ पर भरोसा नहीं कर रहे हैं ना। अच्छा ठीक है, ठीक है, ओके। अब हमें इनको कन्विंस करने के लिए ये पहले जैसे ही बनाना है, ये बन गया क्या? नहीं ना, दोनों जुड़ गए। तो ऐसा करते हैं कि हम इस पर वो चमत्कारी मलहम लगाते हैं जो असलम बाबा का है, आप इसको पकड़ लीजिए, बिकॉज यू मे थिंक दैट आई चेंज द रोप, सो यू होल्ड इट। कभी कभी खींचता है, छोड़ना नहीं, कस खींचता है कभी। अच्छा, अब मैं इस पर एक गोंद लगाता हूँ, ये गोंद मैं जेब में रखा हूँ क्योंकि इट इज वेरी वेरी ऑक्सीजन सेंसिटिव, लाइट सेंसिटिव, सो आई केप्ट इट इन माय पॉकेट। यू एनीबडी फ्रॉम द बायोलॉजिकल साइंसेस, दे विल नो दैट देयर लॉट ऑफ वेरी, ही इज फ्रॉम बायोलॉजी,
या ही हिमसेल्फ फ्रॉम,
सो आई विल अप्लाई दिस गम हियर। Can you see it? No. No. Only Punyavan can see it. Can you see it?
Oh. Yes.
Oh, you can see it. Yeah, you can see it. Punyavan. आप तो इसको लगाते हैं। Done by one guy called as Pandrimale Swami in Chennai. Anybody from Chennai here? This Pandrimale Swami, you wouldn't have seen him because he died in 1973. His favorite thing was, you know, generally people go to these fellows when you are in trouble, and most of the time the problems are in between two people. So he would say, "Ninge inda kai irunda maadhiri ortha da irunda." That means, like this rope, both of you are one. फिर ऐसा हो गया कि कोई बीच में आ गया और आपके संबंध काट दिए, इसको इधर काटो, क्या होता है? दो टुकड़े होते हैं, ज्वाइन करो, नहीं होता। ये क्यों नहीं होता? वो बोलता है कि शनिदेव का तिरछी नजर पड़ी है तुम पर, क्योंकि सारी देव देवताएं सीधी नजर से देखते हैं, लेकिन शनिदेव तिरछी नजर से देखते, वो पड़ी है तुम पर, इसलिए तुम ये नहीं कर सकते। बाद में कहता है शनिदेव को हम पूजा करेंगे, और कहता है कि अब तुम इसको बीच में काटो, काटना नहीं, पकड़ो भैया, पकड़ो, देखिए बीच में पकड़ रहा है ना, राइट? सो दिस वाज द पीस व्हिच ही कट, एंड इट इज देयर इन माय पॉकेट। एंड हाउ डिड इट कम? Even very intelligent people like you will find it difficult to find out. It's all... You know how, what I cut? It was like this. It was like this. I said two pieces. one like this and one like this. Then I said, I'm joining the two pieces. And then I said, I'm going to apply the gum. I'm going to pull this and put it in my mouth. Before we expose this fellow, whose name was Alex Orbito, he came from Philippines. He came to Bangalore and he operated on people and he was taking out things from their stomach. So I showed that demonstration for some TV channels and it was shown all over Karnataka. And I did that in many places in North India because another guy called as Aslam Baba had started from Karnataka. He was also operating with his bare hands. So all these fellows are frauds. Bilkul frauds. They are all applying tricks to cheat people in the name of supernatural healing, supernatural powers and supernatural water.